Now we will understand the current limit constant with V is constant with the temperature. Here there are three pins available. V in is pin number 1, V out is pin number 3, and V and adjustment or ground pin is pin number 2 in IC LM317. So these are the pins which are being used in the circuit. Now the applications associated with LM317 adjustable voltage regulator from 1.25 volts to 37 volts, digitally selected outputs, then power follower, then constant current battery charger for nickel cadmium batteries. It has a fully protected lamp driver. Protected lamp driver means it is connected with the circuit in such a way that if there is any voltage fluctuation, there is a lamp available which works like a flasher or which produces the flickering effect. Flickering means on off effect, that there is change in the load. Then we have a lamp flasher which does the same work of flickering. It is used in high gain amplifiers where you are using very high voltage in order to regulate any electronic application. It has 5 volts logic regulator with electronic shutdown, means there is a thermal cutoff. As the temperature rises, there is saturation obtained across the junctions. Then we have slow turn on 15 volt regulator. Rest all applications associated are being explained in chapter number 2. We will discuss them further. Now here they have given two examples of monostable multivibrator operation, where R is equal to 10 kilo ohms and C is 0.02 picofarad. Picofarad matlab multiplied by 10 to the power of minus 12. What is the width of the output pulse? In monostable operation, width is equal to W, which is equal to 1.1 into RC, which is equal to 1.1 into 10 into 10 to the power of 3. We always write kilo ohms as 10 to the power of 3 multiplied by 0.022 into 10 to the power of minus 12. Always keep the minus 12 or minus 9 or minus 6 or minus 3 without performing any operation. Perform the other part of the multiplication, you get the answer as 2.42 into 10 to the power of minus 10 seconds. So if you reschedule it or resolve it, you got 242 picoseconds. So this is the answer for which your monostable multivibrator's LED will remain on. If you want to check this answer, you need to use your mobile phone for recording, without which the output of the operation will not be experienced, because this part is not experienced by a human eye, because our eye has a capability to understand persistence of vision, which is 1/10 of the second. Okay, now we move to the next numerical. In the next numerical, we will study about a stable multivibrator. This is used to generate square wave, rectangular wave, any wave which is being given as a constant output is being studied through a stable multivibrator. In a stable multivibrator, we are using IC555, where RA is 10 kilo ohms, RB is 2 kilo ohms, and C is 0.0047 microfarad. What are the output frequency and the duty cycle? In a stable timer, the output frequency F is being given by 1.44 divided by RA plus RB plus 2RB into C. So the respective values are being substituted. After that, the output received is 21.88 kilohertz. Then comes the duty cycle D. Duty cycle D is calculated by RA plus RB divided by RA plus 2RB into 100%. After substituting the values of in kilo ohms, we are getting the duty cycle as 85.7%. The practical which we will perform on monostable and unstable multivibrator in the college on this part of the chapter we hear. So the in monostable I will give you various kinds of time in seconds in order to design the monostable multivibrator with the respective components like resistor and capacitor, which play an important role in designing the monostable multivibrator. In a stable multivibrator, we will design the unstable multivibrator for 70% duty cycle. So if you want, you can practice this at home. If you put 70% at D, or you can put 0.70 is equal to RA plus RB divided by RA plus 2RB, you get one equation. Then if you take the capacitance of the capacitor as 0.001 microfarad, then you will get the, and if your frequency is taken as 5 megahertz, you will get RA plus 2RB equal to some other value. You solve it by simultaneous equations, you will obtain the values of RA and RB, and this is how we will perform the practical. The summary of this chapter is been available. The reason why we are using LM317, the easiest way to find the output here, R1 and R2 are the two specific values which are required to attach with IC LM317 in order to receive a specific kind of output between the range of 1.25 volts to 37 volts. Okay, with this we are done with the chapter study of integrated circuits. I will explain this chapter in further detail associated with the numericals part, and then I will also explain the usage of this chapter into your day-to-day life. With this, we are done for the day. Thank you.